in the house of Saul. His father being Jonathan. So the nurse was expecting that the father and the grandfather and the father will come back.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. And become a father. And take care of the child. But the Bible says, because of the situation that this child was in, this child got this thing and got paralyzed. He was not even able to talk. He was still young. And then he was taken to the place called Lodibar. He was taken to the place of no communication. He was taken to a place of no communication. Where he could not communicate. Where he could not share what was happening in his life. Where he could not share the pain that was inside. Because I believe that this child has waited for some time to be a king. But when he looked at his condition, he saw that he would not qualify to be a king. Because a condition sometimes it takes us to a place of no communication. Because sometimes
Bye.
the nurse dropped.
But the nurse was weak.
Hey!
Hallelujah!
I wonder how good nurses.
I wonder if you are nurse of a new layer now.
I wonder how good nurses.
I wonder if you are nurse of a new layer now.
I wonder how good nurses.
I wonder if you are nurse of a new layer.
Are we not dropping people?
As far as we are not abandoned.
Are we not dropping people?
As far as we are not abandoned.
Are you not dropping people?
As far as we are not abandoned.
The people that God brought it to you.
Abandoned yes, so much is so.
I wonder did you take care of them?
I want to walk out.
Did you take care of them?
I want to
now. And the Bible declares
that
when David was worried,
why
he called a man, a servant of Saul, a former servant of Saul, and
said,
Ziba, go and fetch
Mephibosheth.
Elodibar. Oh God!
Oh God!
I pray that you may raise the zippers of this time. The zippers of this time. People who are not afraid to go to Elodibar and shake, and they come with them. When I imagine this, when he went to carry in chapter
9.
Mephibosheth was old.
Hallelujah.
He was old. He was no longer a child. Now,
Gogo,
when Ziba went there,
wafika phaya,
she saw
wambona
a big man.
Wabona indoda enkulu endala. Ngelisho akho bangethe
umsandu. He was lame.
Wayengakwazi uhamba.
And he was given an instruction to bring him back. But the challenge in bringing him back is
going
to be a struggle. He could not walk. Because David said, I want him to eat in my table. To eat in my table. And the Bible says, he went to fetch
him.
I could imagine when you find a person that he cannot walk. Both legs are paralyzed. Now, I believe that Ziba had to carry. Because he could not walk.
But
he had to carry.
Oh, the and even put him in his back.
And say, I'm taking you home. Oh God, I am taking you home. I am bringing you back to the king. I am bringing you back to the master.
That
is the table waiting for you. That you need to have. And he carried him to the table. To the table. To the table. Carried him to the table. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The Bible declares that Mephibosheth, he also had a son. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That means we speak about an old person. He was old. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
He moved from Lodibar to Jerusalem. When they describe it, to the place of peace, the position of peace. They took him from Lodibar to the place of more communication. A place of peace. Ziba said, you belong to the table.
What